Yeah, how's it going, everybody? YouTube's Xplict91. You know, I had this for a while, but I never did a review on it. So I'm just do a little mini review on this. Yeah, there's a lot of like background noises, so hopefully this won't interrupt with the actual review. So I'm doing a review on the Retro Mini. This is a portable Nintendo player. It actually uses regular batteries right here. See? There we go. This is 4 AA batteries, and it's actually pretty unique little thing. The screen is really small though. See, look how small the screen is. Don't worry, it has a screen protector. But look how small the screen is. It's not really that big. If you want to compare it, let me see if I have a spare quarter right here. Let me see. There you go. That's a quarter right there. So look how big. It's pretty much a quarter and a dime. That's how big the freaking screen is. It's not really that big, but then again, it's pretty decent. It has two speakers right here. Speakers are pretty loud. Volume is in the bottom. And there's an audio port right there. And it comes with the AV out. This is for when you connect it, go straight to your TV with the three colors, the red, white, and yellow. There you go, red and yellow. The on switch is right here. The design is fairly simple. Has the D-pad right here, start, pause, the select. I don't know where they put select here, but and the BA, and the reset right here. I don't know why they put the reset here. It really is a really bad construction quality on that. Because if you're pushing B like that, you might accidentally push the reset button, and that's not really good. So let's go ahead with the machine itself. The battery life of the machine is fairly good. It's about, with the 4 AA's, you could probably get maybe up to 2 to 3 hours of gameplay. Pretty good for late night sessions if you just want to play at night without no one knowing. It's pretty good. So actually, let me pause this for a second, get a better close-up on this. Hold on. I tried looking around, but I couldn't get a good focus on this. But okay, let's just go ahead and go with the gameplay on this machine. So I got a Nintendo game here. Room. I got Super Contra. So to put in the game is a top loader, so it's installed from the top. But you have to really push it in. I mean, you can't just like slide. You have to really put force on it, and I have to use my whole palm on that and push it really tight. And sometimes it won't work, but you have to feel it out. So when you turn it on, you should get the There you go, the start. You know, I think I'm gonna have to focus this again and get a better. Hold on, let me see if I can try to zoom it in for you guys. Zoom, zoom, zoom. Hopefully that's good, clear enough. All right. Hopefully you guys can see that. If not, I'll try my best. Right, that's pretty decent. All right, so like I said, the build quality is right here. They have to start selecting AB. So let's go ahead and try this. I think I might have to pause and refocus. Alright, I kind of refocused it a little bit so you can see everything. Alright, now let's go ahead and go with the actual game itself. It's in color, everything's in color. The volume is fairly loud, so actually, I'm gonna lower the volume. Okay, from the bottom. So I'm gonna put the volume a little bit lower. And let's go ahead and just start. So everything works, all the buttons work. It feels kind of flimsy. The B and A don't really respond as well as you want them to respond. So I'm gonna zoom back a little bit so you guys can see the whole gameplay. See? So when you play, I'm actually playing from the camera, so I can't really see from the mini screen. So, oops, fell. All right, let me actually look overhead. So the buttons don't feel like a regular Nintendo control. It feels really bad, and sometimes while playing, you might actually touch the cartridge. And when touching the cartridge, it actually might, you know, reset the game and or freeze the game. So you have to be careful about that. Like I said, the build quality is pretty decent, but they had the reset right here, so you might accidentally push the reset button, which is really bad. So overall, it's pretty decent. Like the D-pad feels really spaced out, and it don't really feel that good when you play the game. It feels like your fingers about to slide off, even though you're not even touching it that much. And like again, games like Contra and stuff don't really fit well because since the screen is so small, you can barely see where the bullets going. And on the camera, you could probably see the bullets, but in person, the bullets are not really that like noticeable. So like I said, games like Contra are not really that recommended playing on this thing. If you want to play, go for it. And it really does look good at night. And you can't really do that much complicated moves like a shoot down, but because you actually walk forward. Like when you try to push down, you actually move forward, which is not good too if you want a little bit more precision. Okay, so that's how Contra plays on this. Contra plays very decent. I don't have any other games. So, actually, I think I do. I have a Double Dragon and Ninja Gaiden and stuff. So let's go ahead and switch the game out. Now, for game switching, oh, here's the reset button. So look, and that's how it is. So if you're in the middle of a match, then you accidentally push that, it really makes you mad. So yeah, but the dual speakers are nice, and the TV out is pretty good. So you want to play on the big screen. I can't really show you that because I lost the cable, but I could buy another cable pretty easily. So let's go ahead and turn this off. And you, again, to pull it out, you have to really use strength. This doesn't slide out very simple, so you actually have to yank it off. There we go. I had to separate that. And let's see. I got to go through my other games. Let's go with one of my favorite games of all time, Ninja Gaiden 2. This is the games I grew up with, so I didn't really care for Mario back then, so I actually like Ninja Gaiden and Mega Man and all that. So let's go ahead and start this. Let's see if you load it up first try. No, it did not. So again, it does feel like a Nintendo. Got the look. There we go. There we go. That should be better. That's it. And again, this is the screen is so small, you can barely see. It's like the same size as a quarter, so you have to make do. Same like that. And get confused too when you push select. I'm so used to like select and start right here, but they put it, I don't know, very awkward. But again, you can find these machines in a lot of places. They sell roughly for 34 to 40 bucks, depends on the location. I actually bought this one from a friend of mine. He sold it to me for I think for 10 bucks. But then again, I got it from a friend. But if you buy it in the store, you have to pay an arm and a leg. But again, if you're gonna recommend buying this, I recommend looking for other sources. I might buy another portable system like the GPX to review on that, which is a emulating system that actually accepts all emulators. So I might try that out, and it's around like 60 bucks, I think. But again, this machine is pretty good for casual gamers or who wants to show off to friends. But it's pretty decent. I mean, you can't really go wrong for something portable. But again, it's not really as responsive. So if you're looking at this like at websites like ThinkGeek.com or something, I recommend thinking again. So if you really do want it just to have it or to add it to your collection, go for it. I mean, it is a really nice system. But I mean, if you can find an alternative or better system out there, which I'll try to find, I recommend looking somewhere else. But since the camera's all focused on it, it looks big, but it's actually really small as to the comparison of the to the quarter. So, but again, this is something basic, something nice, good for geek conventions if you know what I'm talking about. So again, so hopefully this review was pretty basic and simple, and if you say if I recommend it, yeah, I recommend it for collectors, but if you're planning on using it a lot for gaming, I recommend looking somewhere else because it's not really that worth the money in the stores, which is like 30 to 40 bucks. And again, you know, today's economy is not that easy unless you're rich. Go for it. And that's about it. Hopefully this was a little bit informative. If not, I try it again. This is Xplict91, and I'm out. Catch you guys later.